A very good o'clock to all the students. Here I am, Amisha ma'am, your physics teacher. Students, today I am here to start our chapter number 23, that is simple harmonic motion. Okay, so before starting this chapter, let's clear a few terms related to it. First one is periodic motion. Okay, what is periodic motion? Which repeats itself in a fixed period of time. Whenever there is a repetition in something after a fixed period or a given period of time, we say that the particle or that substance is in periodic motion. The best example we have is Earth revolving around the sun. Okay, now coming to oscillatory motion. Oscillatory, you have already heard, that is to and fro type motion. Or I can say that here particle moves to and fro about its mean position. Mean position, say, within the confined limit, within two confined limits, and repeats its motion after a fixed interval of time. It also repeats its motion after the fixed period of time, but within its to and fro. To and fro is this one. Okay, moving here again, coming back. Okay, then the best example, you can say a movement of a table fan. If you have seen, it moves here, then it moves here. Again, it moves, goes there, then here. Okay, this is the example of oscillatory motion. Now coming to your simple harmonic motion. So it is a type of oscillatory periodic motion. Means it is a type of both motions, that is oscillatory also and periodic. So I have said here is, it is a type of oscillatory periodic motion in which acceleration relates to position in a very simple way, where acceleration is related to the position, in which simple way, where acceleration is directly proportional to minus x, that is a relative position. So I can say that after removing this proportionality sign, we will get the constant, that is a barabar minus omega square x, where this is omega. Okay, and omega is an angular frequency. So angular frequency, I can write omega barabar 2 pi f. F is frequency. What is frequency? That is the number of oscillation in 1 second. 1 second mein kitne number of oscillations hai, tells the frequency. So I can write here omega s 2 pi by t, because your frequency is 1 upon time period. So in place of frequency, I can replace it by 1 upon t. So here it will, I will get omega is 2 pi by t. Now let's discuss about some examples related to SHM, that is simple harmonic motion. First example is simple pendulum. If you have seen the pendulum, its movement is here, then it goes here. Okay, simple pendulum type of clock. Or you can say girl on a swing. Koi bachche agar ye swing par jhule par hai, to that motion is also a simple harmonic motion. Another example here is tuning fork. Students, tuning fork, if you have seen, it is of this shape. Okay, it is a shape of where two, you can say these prongs are used. They are called prongs. Okay, prongs, when strike on an object, it vibrates or oscillates. What prongs do? When we took this tuning fork and we take it, and when strike on any object, it vibrates. Now it vibrates in two different ways. First one is antiphase and second one is in phase. From the diagram you see antiphase. Antiphase means when they both moves in the opposite phases, opposite direction. If one is going prong here, one is vibrating here, then it is called antiphase, that is opposite or out of phase. Second one is in phase. In phase means what? The same phase. If after striking, it is vibrating in a same direction. So you can say that the tuning fork is in phase direction or same phase direction. So the tuning fork is a best example of simple harmonic motion. Next, you can say the example is guitar string. Students, guitar string, on leaving the guitar string after playing, it oscillates in SHM, that is simple harmonic motion. Now the equation we have is A, acceleration is equal to minus omega square x. Omega square x. Now on differentiating x, once we get v, velocity. On differentiating it, dx by dt will give you definitely what? V na, velocity. Okay, but on differentiating it again, v, that is d2x upon dt square, we'll get the acceleration a. So in place of a, I can write d2x upon dt square barabar minus omega square x. This is the second order differential equation. Okay, on solving it, this solution is not there in our syllabus, but on solving it, we'll get x is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. Here a is our amplitude, x is the position at any time with respect to the mean position. Whatever the mean position is, it with respect to it, whatever the position comes is your x. X is the position at any time t, whatever time is there with respect to the mean position. A here is the amplitude, and now omega t plus phi. Omega t plus phi together is a word we are using, term we are using it as a phase, where omega is angular frequency and phi is initial phase, or you can say a phase constant. Okay, now let's come to A. What is amplitude? Amplitude we have discussed in our previous classes also. It is the maximum displacement from the mean position. Now what is this mean position? Mean position is the equilibrium position where net force becomes zero. If net force is zero, then definitely acceleration, net acceleration is also zero, students. Now just look about phase here. Phase here is what? The term omega t plus phi. If t is zero, if t is equal to zero, that is time is zero, then phase that is phi. It tells the state of motion, you can say, or you can say state of motion means what? The position or direction of a particle at t is equal to zero, right? So phase is what? It tells the state of a motion, or you can say position or direction of a particle at t time zero. Therefore, it is called initial phase phi. So omega t plus phi, that is phase. What I can say, it tells the state of motion of the particle at any time t. At any time t, if at time is zero, then the phase is phi. Okay, but at any given time, you can say, what is phase? It tells the state of motion of that particle, that is omega t plus phi. Okay, now phi depends upon which factors? First one is initial conditions, that is where particle is or where it is moving. Second one is equation of SHM, that is simple harmonic motion. Now, motion of a particle is said to be in SHM if, what is a condition when a particle is said to be in motion in SHM? First condition is acceleration of particle is directly proportional to its displacement from mean position. Acceleration we have discussed should be directly proportional to its what? Displacement na x from the mean position where we are calculating. Second one is the acceleration must always remains always remains towards its mean position. Acceleration should be in the direction or towards the direction of, or it remains same towards the mean position. Okay, now some basic terms related to periodic motion, that is displacement. The instantaneous position of a particle इन ऑसिलेटरी मोशन, ऑसिलेटरी मोशन में पार्टिकल की पोजिशन जो है इंस्टेंटेनियस, बाद में फ्रॉम इट्स मीन पोजिशन से कहाँ पर पहुँची, इज डिफाइंड एज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द पार्टिकल एंड इट्स एसआई यूनिट इज स्टूडेंट्स मीटर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट टाइम पीरियड. टाइम पीरियड इज वॉट? टाइम पीरियड ऑफ एन ऑसिलेटरी मोशन is defined as the time interval after which a particle repeats its motion. That time interval after which the particle is repeating its motion after a fixed time interval is represented by its time period. It is represented by capital T. Now, frequency, number of oscillations completed by a particle in oscillatory motion is known as its frequency. It is represented by nu. Relation between frequency and time is frequency nu is equals to 1 upon T, as I have told you. Okay. So students, do watch this video up till here only. I will continue the topics. Till then, also go through the topics which are given in your book itself. Okay, thank you.